What's up, guys? In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can log into your virtual environment. Yeah, you might ask yourself, oh, I created it. But yeah, sometimes you might have forgotten how to log into it. So I'm just gonna show you can do that. So first thing first, we're gonna see where is our virtual environment. So let's go to our documents. Depending where you kept your virtual environment, it's in your D drive or on your local disk C. So first thing, we have to locate where it is, and I kept mine in my document, so you can see it right here. So I'm now going to come into my command prompt and navigate my way there. So we start with CD document. Now you have to make sure you spell it correctly, because if you don't, you are going to end up having an error. So if I remove this S, that I'm gonna get, the system cannot find the path specified. So let's do that again and put our S, then click enter. So now we can now see we are now in documents. Now the name of the folder where my project is project_7. So I'm just gonna type that now. Okay. Then _7. Yep, and don't forget to type your CD space, then enter. So now I'm in my project_7. I'm going to activate my virtual environment. Now it's always good to give your virtual environment a name that you can easily remember. So best option, just call it Vim. So I'm just gonna call it that. Backslash. Now it's a little bit different if you're using Windows or you're using Mac. Mac is a little bit different. I think you have to add a $ and you might use a bin instead of script. So depending on your system, just use what is appropriate. Then type active. Gotta spell that correctly. Activate. Yep, got it. .bat. You can also activate your virtual environment without this last part, this bat. You could just type activate, then enter. Well, I rather just put the bat there. Take note that the S right here is a capital letter, but sometimes you can also use a small letter. But the major one you should not forget is the last N, S at the end. That's very important. It must be scripts. Okay? So enter. Okay. It did work. But sometimes I do end up having an error there. Okay, so right now we are in our virtual environment and it's activated. So look at it right here. So our virtual environment has been activated. So right now I'm going into my project. So because I already know the name of my project, so I can easily just type it. But if you don't, you can just come into your project 7 where my project is, click here, virtual environment, click project. So you can see I know the name project_state7. Yep, then this is my app and my project. So let's go back. First, before I can enter into my project, I first need to CD into my virtual environment, like into my Vim folder. So let's enter there permanently now and type Vim. So I have to first enter into my virtual environment with an in now. Can I see it here? So from here, I can now enter into my project. So cd project. Then underscore. So always give your project a name that you can easily remember so that you don't mix your project with your app. Okay, so I'm in, enter, yay. So from right here, now I'm in my project, I can now run my server. So to run the server, I just need to type Python, yep, manage dot py, then type run and be sure, okay, run server, then press enter. So you have to wait for some time and boom, it is activated. So I just need to copy this so that I can copy. Oh, yep, sometimes this add to copy this. Okay, open a new window, then paste it in. Boom. So from here, this is my project, and if I do a /admin, boom, I'm in my admin.